when we are talking about your programs, could you break it down for us? Like, what does a typical worldview program look like? What does it comprise?
So we have four large domains.
Okay.
So global citizenship, environment conservation, healthcare, and urban sustainability.
Right, right.
So I'll just take an example of an urban sustainability program. So this is called FutureSake.
Okay.
We've actually developed this program with a lot of agencies, including some of the government affiliates in Singapore, where we've kind of put together a intense study program where students get to go and understand the back end of a city, which is, you know, at the forefront of urban sustainability at this point of time.
Right.
You know, just to give you a figure, Singapore had 95% dependency on Malaysia for water.
Right.
And that treaty is going to die in 2041. So they have to, you know, kind of figure out their own sources of water. It's a national security issue. Can you imagine?
Right.
I mean, we are still debating connecting rivers, etc. But for them, it's a national security issue. If you take food, they import everything from abroad as such. So they are going vertical with food farming because they need to have their sources secure.
Right.
So it's a very interesting 100-year plan that they have where they're also looking at it being a city in a garden against some gardens in the city.
Right.
So that's their strategic theme of how do they make a city in a garden. And they've achieved that at a practical level because 33% of Singapore at a land cover level is green now.
Okay.
For a small city which is, you know, landlocked, they've taken their armed forces underground and they've made whatever is on the ground green.
Right.
So it's phenomenal. It's a good case study to study for students. It's not, the idea is not to emulate Singapore and come here and, you know, say, okay, we'll make Bombay
or
Singapore.
That won't work either. Yeah.
That will not work. I mean, for politicians, it might work where they say, you know, you want to make Bombay, Shanghai, and London, Delhi, London.
Yeah.
That's rhetoric. You know, we need to make the best Bombay possible, the best Delhi possible for ourselves in our context. And that's where we only encourage them to see how Singapore, within its framework, within its resources, is doing the best it can.
That's your international program?
That's our international program.
Correct.
I'll also come to the one which we deliver in India.
Yeah.
But so this is a typical 7-day program where they go through an academic course as well, where it's a problem-based learning course, which is delivered by some of the best global universities.
Okay.
And then we deliver around it an entire program making Singapore itself the classroom.
Okay.
So they study the water story of Singapore by visiting these places where the water story is happening as such.
Right.
So the land use, the farming stories, the food story, the entire energy. I mean, for such a small country, how do you figure out energy? They're dependent on the world. But they've done it brilliantly by collaborating with, you know, a lot of countries nearby. They've made an extended market for themselves. And today, they're the forefront of pushing, you know, the frontiers of urban sustainability. So we take them through these different modules around, you know, biodiversity, water, waste, etc. And then we bring them back and encourage them to make an audit of their own neighborhood, home, and school.
So that way it doesn't end
it
with
the program.
It
doesn't end with the
program.
It's not the only the intervention of the program or the event of the program which is important. For us, the continuum is more important.
Right.
So we bring them back, we encourage them to take up projects in these influence zones. We have a program in set in the outdoor, you know, near a forest. We have our campus between Hyderabad and Bangalore.
Exactly, yeah.
So I'll also cover the program which I was talking about in India.
Yeah.
So we've set this entire program in the outdoors abutting a forest. And we have designed this program in such a way that all the experiences are connected to those outdoors. So we do farming, forestry programs.
Okay.
We do fitness from a health point of view. Food is a big discussion there. But we also have rooted all this in the geographical terrain.
Many times we forget
that every market in the world is geographically connected.
True.
But our education is not geographically connected. That's where we are losing the entire, the monolith of what the education system has become is not letting the nuances of local come into the picture for students very early on in life.
How do you ensure that happens?
So what we do is we base it completely on geography. So it starts with the terrain. You have to understand the terrain. Then you will understand why the soil is like that. Then you have to understand why the weather is like that. Then you have to understand why the trees are like that. And then you start understanding their impact on humanity.
Right.
So the culture has come in Deccan Plateau the way it is because of what the geography is.
Right.
You eat because of the geography.
Right.
You breathe, your lung capacity is because of geography, your you know, your entire biological system is because of the geography.
Right.
So we start there